My name is Joe, and today I'm going to be doing a beginner to horse ownership manual. Costs. This section will break down the costs of owning a horse.
The prices vary greatly, but the average cost for a horse is $3,000. Quarter horses, certain thoroughbreds, Arabians, and pretty much any untrained horse would be the cheapest option, costing anywhere from a few hundred to a few thousand. The most expensive horses will be certain thoroughbreds, Dutch warm blood, South Francais, and standard breds, costing anywhere from 50,000 to the millions. The thoroughbreds that cost the most will be racehorses, well, famous ones at least. The average cost for a bucket of feed is around $40, whereas the average cost for hay is around $140 per ton of it, and yes, you are going to need a lot if you buy a horse. These things are hay-eating machines. The average cost for bags of treats is around $10, but it gets much more expensive, or you can just get them for a dollar. The average cost for treatment for the common illness colic will cost around $4,200, whereas the cost for just a regular vet visit is around $200, and will cost about $450 per year, because you need to take your horse in sometimes. To have a farrier trim a horse, it'll cost around $30, and it must be done every 6 to 8 weeks to keep your horse healthy. The average cost for halters is around $20, but it can get more expensive the more high-end they are. A blanket will cost around $100 for simple blankets, and up to $500 or in the thousands for more high-end ones. Lead ropes are the cheapest, costing $5 or $10, and fly masks, like the black one in this white horse, will cost around $20 to $30. A shelter in a field costs around $700, but is not needed as shown in this field. There are three types of boards which are recommended if you do not have the space for a horse. Full care board will cost around $700 a month, but takes care of everything, so you don't have to do anything. They'll take care of your horse completely. Pasture board will take full care of your horse, but the horse will always be out in pasture like these guys are here. It normally costs around $300 a month. Then there's self-care board that only costs around $100 a month, but you have to take care of your horse. They only take your horse from inside to pasture. That's all they do. If you board your horse, you won't have to worry about spending money on fencing, but if you don't, you will have to buy fencing for your horse. Electric fence is the cheapest, costing around $7 per square foot. Then there are wood fences, like this one, costing $10 to $15 per square foot again. And PVC fences are the most expensive, costing $15 to $25 per square foot. It is recommended you get wood or PVC fencing for more rowdy horses.
This section will cover the health of horses.
The average diet for a working horse is grass during the day, like these guys are eating, and hay and grain whenever they come in. They can have snacks such as fruit, vegetables, special horse treats, peppermints, that kind of stuff, and they need constant access to food and water. Hay nets are a good idea. A common illness for horses, strangles, has symptoms such as a high fever, coughing, making yellow discharge from the eyes and nose. Colic, another common disease, is characterized by excessive rolling, muscle cramps, gas, and a high heart rate. There are many more than just these two diseases, but these are the most common ones, so horse owners will need to know. Certain treats only cost a dollar, but others can cost upward of 60 or 70. Apples, carrots, peppermints, any other fruits and vegetables, really, but horses tend to prefer apples and carrots, work as treats for them. And you can make your own homemade treats with apples, carrots, hay, grains, peppermint, and other fruits and vegetables, like stated earlier.
This section will cover the miscellaneous parts of all horses.
In temperate areas with mild winters, like Pennsylvania, horses can live fully on 5 or so acres of land throughout the year. 1/10 of an acre is the minimum space for a horse, but if you do this, you have to feed them hay and exercise them, as they just won't be getting enough food or exercise. When you have your horse inside, it's always a good idea to have access to hay. A hay nut's a good idea. Horses can be kept together, or should actually, but if there are more males than females, the males will fight for dominance.
all male or all female herds do work, and it is recommended for newer people to horses. While human contact does help, horses need to be with other horses to stay happy and healthy. The daily schedule for owning a horse should be giving your horse fresh food and water when you wake up, and then turning them out if they aren't already. And whenever you get the chance, check your horse for injuries. This will include anything from cuts and bruises to ticks and symptoms for diseases. Before you get out of bed, feed them again and refill their water bucket, and take them in if there's going to be bad weather. They're not always in pasture, make sure they always have fresh hay accessible. Again, hay net.
This section will cover the advanced parts of the horse.
There are general breed attitudes, but each horse is different, so you're going to have to experiment to figure out which horse is right for you. Quarter horses are all-round horses with calm attitudes and are generally not flighty. Warm bloods are good horses for shows with their natural ability to jump in calm nature. This horse over here is actually a warm blood. A draft horse is an excellent choice if you want your horse to drive a cart or help around the farm and are usually not scared of anything. Have foals on their own, so if you put a male and a female together in a pasture, make sure at least one of them is fixed. A horse mom can and will deliver and take care of its baby on its own, but the baby should be standing and walking within the first hour. If it's not, it is recommended to intervene. Foals are very playful and often don't know their boundaries, and they will treat you as another horse unless taught otherwise, so you're going to need to train them pretty early on. Hams are not required, but are very helpful for training. And if you're new or you're working with a difficult horse, a professional trainer is recommended. The most important thing to train a horse is that you are in charge no matter what. You're going to have to train that to any horse you have, even if you're not going to train anything else. Nice. Remember how we use our-